Welcome back to my channel. For those of you who don't know me, I'm your girl Chrissy with 3 S's and 3 Y's. Thank you for tuning in today. So today we are going to be talking about Hue to Beauty, which some of you may know. I've never done Hue to Beauty on my channel before. Hue to Beauty is new to me. The look and the makeup that I'm looking and you're looking at is Hue to Beauty. Like, and she makes me feel so pretty. Okay, like she makes me feel really, really, really pretty. And I just can't be thankful for the amount of money that I spent on this, and it really came out with a good quality makeup. Sometimes you spend a certain amount of money on something and the quality is still not there, or you feel like you wasted your money. And these days you don't need to feel like you wasted money. So today we're going to talk about Hue to Beauty's new products, which some of you may know. She has a water jelly. There it is. She has a water jelly primer. And she has a new faux stick, which is the foundation stick. Her new foundation faux stick. This is the shade Toffee 420 NG. And I used the shade Gingerbread. I had got 3 of the faux sticks to try, but I absolutely love all 3 of them, so I'm gonna keep all 3 of them. And then we're going to be talking about the Naughty Nude palette, which I'm seriously obsessed with. This palette here is literally the best palette I've gotten my hands on. The price wise, okay, yeah, scary, but the quality, I don't even have primer on my eyes. And I've already did a couple things this morning, and I haven't touched my makeup or my face at all, and I'm looking pretty freaking good still. So this is the palette that is going to have Miss Huda talked about for decades, because when she stepped out with this palette, she stepped out with a good thing. Okay. So you guys, as we tune into this video about the Hue to Beauty experience and all her new products, go ahead, and if you want to see this, go ahead and stay tuned to the video. If you want to see how I got this look, stay tuned to the video. And if you want to hear all my messages that I have for you at the end, stay tuned to the end of the video.
I'ma throw it back like a 90s recap. Anything can happen, I'ma show my ass. It's a bad bitch B-Day, so ain't no team relay. I break big ranks, baby girl, big frame. I'm coming in pre-game, Cuban link designer jeans. I'm the crystal ball, shake my ass and make it rain. Tomorrow is a new day, I won't remember your face. I don't block with pigeons, I have no intentions. Bend it up.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. For those of you who are new, I'm your girl Chrissy, 3 S's 3 Y's, and today we are going to be doing something I've never done on this channel before, introducing Hue to Beauty products. Now, I spent a good amount of money on this, I'm not even gonna lie, she's pricey, but I did test her out before, got on camera today, and she's worth it. And I'm just gonna do this look on camera today for you guys, because I already tested out these products, which I got a bunch of Hue products in front of me, you will see. I tested out these products and they're lovely. Like, I'm at a loss for words. Like, Miss Hue, congratulations. And this isn't the least of it. I had got the Retrograde Mercury palette added to my collection. She's beautiful. So, if you want to see how I complete this look, sit back, grab a cup of coffee, a cup of tea, and tune the fuck in. Okay guys, I kind of debated if I wanted to go back and forth with coming on with brows or not, but it's simple. I'm just gonna do my brows on camera, and you guys are gonna follow along through my daily process. Now, like I said, we're introducing the Hue palette, and this is the Naughty Nude. There was a couple comments about how they didn't like her face on the packaging, and it comes in a clear box like this. There was a couple comments about how they didn't like her face on the packaging, right? To me, I'm like, this is plain, and I get the Naughty Nude, but I have this sitting in front of me, which is her highlight palette, which is her money looking all glowy. this is a highlight, and it's beautiful, and this is a palette, and it's beautiful, but I like a face on my package. But I get it. She went through, which I watched all the videos on her. She went through a process where she's no longer a CEO of her company. She gave that title to someone else, which she thought was very worthy of it. And that's not why we're here today. We're here because this beauty is in my present. Open it. It's very tightly sealed, and I play in the palette. So you guys know, like, when I play in the palette, look at that fall off. It's fine. Fall off is normal. I don't care. You guys can't be very specific. To me, it's that slippery shade. And excuse my nails, but it's that slippery shade, and it's like, ooh. I put that on my nose as a highlight. It was like, I was glowing. And I'm gonna show you guys what shades we're gonna use, but let's go ahead and jump into my brows. Lately, I've been using, and I did not prepare, so I just woke up and was like, I'm gonna do a big thing on these new products because I enjoyed my look, so whatever. I've been using the Milani brow dip, but today I'm gonna use Anastasia because I'm not really gonna put on brows today. Your girl is just gonna sculpt her brows and shape them a little bit. So excuse me while I do that really quickly. Just yet, first shade I'm going to go into is because I've been using this shade because, like, it has been the shade for me, I guess. Like, it's really been the shade for me. It's Aroused. It's this shade right here, but you guys see me point it before. It's the shade Aroused. I've been literally obsessed with this color. And this is a fluffy Morphe brush, it's 518, and I'm just putting Aroused in my corner. Like I said, since my eyelashes are already done, it's gonna be a little difficult for you guys to see it, but yeah. She's cute, she's orange on my face. I don't know what she'd be on your face, cause this is me with no concealer. Just going into my crease and building up, just like so. And people always complain about the fall off. I love the extra on the extra, okay? Because I'm extra. So when I can get that extra out of the palette, I like to like go into my crease with that just to deepen it, because otherwise you'd be padding hella, or you'd be patting a lot of eyeshadow onto your eye, and people are like, that's the cakey look. It's not really a cakey look, it's just too much. So I'm gonna go in with a nice deep color. It's gonna be the color Spicy, which is right next to Aroused. And I feel like these color shades just really go well with each other. But this is gonna be the shade Spicy. And I could be using this mirror because this is also a really good mirror. And I'm just taking that color inside my crease. And this is just a drugstore brush that I picked up. And as I take that inside my crease, I kind of just build up towards Aroused. And Spicy gives me like a dark plum color. Like, it doesn't really give me like a black or a dark brown. It gives me like a dark plum, which is really cute too. And it looks like a
spicy color, like a spicy plum. And these colors blend really well together. I have no complaints with them blending together. Now I'm obsessed, and I'm going to admit it, I've been obsessed with this color. And it's the color Flower Power right there that I've already dipped my hand into. And I like to just take my finger and like slice it across my eyelid. And like just one swipe, guys. It's so beautiful. And like I just take it and I swipe across my eyelid. Just like that. And we just ducked off in the bathroom today, guys, because everyone's home today. I've been trying to film this video all weekend. Today's Sunday. I've been trying to film this video all weekend, and I couldn't because everyone's been home thanks to the holidays and pandemic and things of the sort. So then I just take like another brush, which I got from the drugstore. And I just fluffing out those, and there's nothing on this brush, so I just take that and I just fluff towards those creases, and that's what it gives me. And these eyeshadows work really well with brushes and with your finger, so you won't lose the pigment at all, like whether you do it with your finger or a brush. That's really important to me. And then I just go back in with that dark color, which is spicy. And I go back into my crease. And it's very important that you do so to get the definition of what you really came for, the deepness that you came for. These eyelashes are really long, but you guys see what I'm talking about. Huda Beauty Full Sticks. I have three different shades. I even got the brush and the jelly primer to go with it. So we're going to start with the jelly primer, which I did use on my face. I tested out. Came in clear packaging. If you guys seen these videos or seen Huda's products before, then you know they normally came with a scent. And this was supposed to be a skin product, and to me it does give you that watery appliance, but once you put it on, it gives you more like a sticky vibe. And you guys apply your primer on how you want to, with extra moisturizer, with little to none. Me, I apply little to none. I have an oily face already, and the less the better. And that Flower Power is literally shining all over my face. So I let that set, right? I let that set. And the beautiful sticks, like I said, I picked up three different shades. Those shades are Churro, Toffee, and Gingerbread. Now, I personally like gingerbread because it matches my tone so well. I don't know if it's neutral in it, or because I'm thinking N means neutral and then G means gold. I don't know the process of how it goes. I just know that those letters mean something. So with that being said, this is the packaging. Like I said, I picked up three different shades, which really matched me really well. So I'm not complaining that I bought three of them. You know what I'm saying? So I'm not gonna try all three on my face, but I'm just gonna start with the one that I like the most, which is gingerbread. It really matches my skin really well, and these are buildable. Should I do all three on my face? No, I'm not. Because as you guys see, this is already a good match for me. It really covers my pores. And I apply as much as I want to because I blend out pretty good. So I picked up the brush, This thing is big. Like they say, it is big. But I picked it up. It's nice. I don't have any complaints with it, honey. Like, it does me good justice. Like, it blends me out really well. My man isn't complaining, so... And I'm just not gonna go underneath my eye because I don't wanna be cakey. I did pick up some concealers from Huda as well that I'm gonna try on my face. And you guys will see. So we'll take away those bags. And just look how well, like, this lighting does me no justice, but look how well. I know my undertone, my natural undertone is red, but you guys don't understand how well this matches me. Like, I never found a foundation to match me like this one. And it's soft and it's matte and the brush is soft, and when you blend, if you blend too much out, you can apply and it doesn't look cakey. I am wearing the Tinashe hair. So now that we established that, I'm gonna take it off and blend my forehead, because it's a problem when you wear makeup and you don't blend your forehead. And it's like, honey. And something happened up there, you forgot a spot or two. And that's when I like to use this end. Now this end is really clean because I tried to save it for video purposes. And I like to take some of my products from off my face and apply it to my forehead. And this really helps me get into areas that I can't get into with this little bottom part. So these products are really useful. I'm not mad at what I spent on them at all. So, and I don't have to worry about blending anymore because I also picked up two concealers. Now I picked up graham cracker and I picked up toasted almond. My favorite is going to be the toasted almond because it seems more of my color, more of my complexion. Now, because it is a silver spoonie, because it is a silver spoonie, I kind of just like dab it into a triangle on my face, and it's cold. And I try to do as minimum as possible. Like I said, the less cakier, the better. And I take the brush and I just like take that little triangle part and I blend up and out. And I go down and I try to get all my blemishes and make a nice little triangle here. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. A little triangle that people do right there. And these concealers blend out really well with a sponge. I'm just using the brush so that you guys can see how well this brush gets into areas. And if I need to spread product, I do. Like, if I have product on one side and one on the other, I spread product because you always want to share. So if I have more product on one side, but I am gonna go in with my favorite Makeup Revolution Banana Deep shade. I always just squeeze some out on the lid. Comes out perfect. Never have any problems with it. I did pick up a Huda Beauty sponge that I did use with my powder. I'm only gonna use with my powder because I like the angle and how it applies. So this sponge, if you guys were like, how was the Huda Beauty sponge? It's lovely for applying powder because the angle is mad pretty. You can get a corner that I really will. And I really like to get in the corner of my eye because that's where all my oils cake up and all my creases happen and all that extra makeup. And just want to make sure you got those areas really well. So, yeah. These products are really nice. Like, I have no problem with my purchase. I don't know whoever's watching, seen Heal Beauty before, but you look at the numbers, you're like, yeah, she's a little expensive, but she's worth it. And I'll tell you that because when I'm inside Sephora or Ulta or any other makeup store, Walgreens, CVS, every drugstore you go to, when I'm inside those stores, price does matter. Yeah. Now I need to use, as everything is said, is a Huda Beauty setting spray. Like I said, they said most of her products have fragrances. This is one of them, but it don't bother me. It smells really, really, really delicious. I'm forgetting anything but the highlight. So once my face is done like setting, I'll come back with the highlight. Okay, everyone, now that my powder has set to the consistency or to the matte that I want it to set, I'm just gonna take a Paris Hilton brush that I picked up. And I'm just gonna buff or blend. I'm gonna dive into that Huda Beauty highlight that I picked up. I wanted to mention to you guys, stay tuned because I'm also going to be testing out this Huda Beauty Complexion Perfection Primer when I do that Mercury video. This one here is the highlight. It's the Maldives, the Barbados, Aruba, and Barbara. So I'm going to take Maldives because I've been obsessed with Maldives. And I'm going to take that on my nose. Oh my god, it's so pretty. And I literally have to smoothen that out because it's such a pretty glow. I picked up the KKW pencil a minute ago. I love the color. It's the color new too, and it came in this packaging, and I've been obsessed with it ever since I got it, and it literally caved on me. I was literally scared to sharpen it till I realized you were supposed to sharpen it. So it's a nice little cute brown. It's a nice little cute brown that I love. And I just popped that all over my lid. So I look like that. And without the light, you guys can see how dark it is. So yeah, that's really pretty. Makeup is beautiful. And you guys, we are done. This is the final look. I hope you guys like what I've shown you guys today, and I definitely enjoyed using this Naughty New palette on my face. I could show you guys the slippery shade. I could pop this slippery shade right here. Look, watch this. There's no shine there. Look, period, no shine. Just a natural shine. When I pop slippery here, and she gives me that rose shade, it's like a total different shine. Like, she's good. She's really good. I got no complaints with this palette. This is a really, 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 really good palette. It may be out of your price range. Yeah, I already know. I spent a handful on these Huda products. It's out of my price range. Yes, I know. But this shit, this right here. Anyway, this product right here is really good. I have no complaints. She did good. Great. Only problem is, I listen to what people say. Keep your face on your packaging if you look this good. Because you look good. So yeah, guys. Thank you for tuning in. Thank you for watching my video. Do not forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Tell me in the comments, what do you guys think I should be doing better? What do you guys think I should be doing next? What do you guys think, you know? I'm really trying to be on my road to 100. So please get me to 100. or more, please. Really going above and beyond with my videos to make sure you guys like them. And don't be scared to comment in the comments below on what you guys think I should be doing better or just doing in general. You guys are awesome. Thank you for tuning in. Thank you for watching. And again, this is Chrissy with Huda Beauty. See you guys later. I hope you guys enjoyed that video as much as I did doing the video. I hope you guys feel like once you buy these products, you can trust my opinion and trust that you will remain beautiful. It is a high price or a definitely. These makeup brands are very expensive these days. But you know what? If you spend money on yourself and you groom yourself, you take care of yourself, you care about yourself, self-care is very important, then you would want to go pick up some Huda Beauty so you can feel as beautiful as I do all day long. Has been all day. It's literally probably like 10 o'clock, maybe even 11. But still, I've been wearing this makeup since 7 and I still feel pretty. Like, you can tell when you're pretty outside of your own home because people are literally staring at you like, how and why does she look like that? But you guys, thank you always for tuning in. Please do not forget to comment below on what you think I should be doing better. And do not forget to like this video if you actually like it. I'm not gonna pressure you to. And don't forget to subscribe. Don't forget to subscribe if you like my videos. And if you want to see more from me, go ahead and ring that bell. I appreciate you all for tuning in. I love you all for watching my videos to the very end. And if you want to see more Huda Beauty, stay tuned because I'm going for the retrograde palette next. I'm going to try and master that palette as well as I did this one. And next time I'm probably going to be a little bit more prepared because I just kind of said I'm going to do this look on the fly and then record it. So you guys, thank you so much for tuning into my video. I love you guys and I'll see you on the next one.